Wow. That event last night was different. It was very different, but it was great. It was great. And I thought I would come somewhere this morning after this big announcement by SpaceX and Yusaku Maezawa, I believe is how you pronounce his name, that SpaceX and planet Earth are coming back to the moon. I decided this morning to come to the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum here in Washington, D.C., because it's a little symbolic. A little over 10 years ago, SpaceX and Elon Musk came here with their Falcon 1 booster to show NASA and the world that they're here. They're here to play ball. Here's the outside. Here's the National Mall. And basically what they did was they put a target on their back. They said, "Here, we're here to play. They're here to take on the Boeings and Lockheed Martins of the world to be the next big player in the space launch business." And now here we are in 2018, and SpaceX is really going for it all. I know a year ago they announced that they would be going to the moon with an unnamed crew member. We now know that is Yusaku Maezawa. I keep mispronouncing this guy's name. I'm gonna get better at this, I promise. This was confirmed by Chris Gebhardt. I'll put the link in the description below in his article. This gentleman was the same person who committed his money to SpaceX a year ago to fly to the moon on the Falcon Heavy, but that's not gonna happen anymore considering Falcon Heavy is now no longer a crew-rated booster. It's just going to be for cargo, which is fine because SpaceX is putting as many of their eggs in the BFR, BFS basket as they can. For now, their top priority is the commercial crew program and putting their satellite partners in the launch, but you know what? You could see all that if you go and watch this. I really wanted to talk about the presentation really quick from what we saw. It was different. The whole thing, as I said earlier, was very different. In typical, let's redo my exposure here. Oh, that's not gonna work, okay. It was typical Elon Musk fashion. He kind of just showed up and started talking. I thought it was adorable that they did have the teleprompters set up, but they were really too low for you to even use them because you were looking over them. So I think somebody at SpaceX corporate was trying to, at some point, probably make this a more constructed corporate type of event that you would expect, but Elon just came in and did what he wanted, which, as we all know, that's what he does. He also started the presentation 20 minutes late. No big deal, not like I was doing anything. But that being said, at the very beginning of the presentation, it kind of felt like to me he was just like getting warmed up. He just wasn't really sure what he was gonna say, so he went really back to a lot of his old talking points, which for people like me who follow a lot of space news, I've heard all that before, but to laymen out in the world who are not indoctrinated into this system, this was all news to them. So anyways, he finally got this groove going and introduced BFR, and we learned some things. BFR is now a little bit taller. It's actually taller than the Saturn V now, which, knowing Elon Musk, he may have just done that, or you know, him and his team may have just done that to be the tallest rocket to ever be created. I don't know, just complete speculation here. Anyways, I did also want to talk about Yusaku Maezawa. This might be one of the most admirable human beings living today. He is a billionaire, yes. So, you know, this is not going to make this guy broke. But he's doing something very admirable. By investing into this, he's going to be inspiring a whole new generation of explorers and creators and artists. Somebody who I personally really wish was here today to see this announcement was Alan Bean. For those of you who don't know who Alan Bean is, Alan Bean was the fourth person to walk on the moon, and he is the only artist to have walked on the moon. He was not sent there as an artist. He was not sent there as an artist, naturally. He was sent there as a pilot and primarily as an astronaut and engineer. But when he got to the moon, he realized one of the biggest mistakes NASA ever made with the moon missions was that they never sent an artist. So Alan Bean, after going to the moon, he did go to Skylab, but he started taking up art classes out here in over near Maryland, out near Patuxent River. Long story short, he got out of the space business after his Skylab mission. Well, not entirely true. He was part of the early shuttle mission, early shuttle era, but that's neither here nor there. Long story short, he got out of NASA and dedicated the rest of his life to painting what he saw on the moon and things he wished he saw on the moon, and also listening to the radio transmissions and recreating moments that may or may not have happened on the moon. Alan died less than a year ago, and I had the pleasure of actually emailing with him over the last several years because I was trying to set up a documentary to do with him, but things just never really lined up. And anyways, I think that if Alan was alive today, he would have been, if he saw this announcement in person, he just would have been so fulfilled and grateful for what Yusaku Maezawa is doing by sending 6 to 8 fellow artists to the moon. And I think that's really what I want to end it on here, is the cultural significance this mission is going to play in the course of human history. When you look at Apollo 8's Earth rising photo, that photo started a whole new movement about the Earth and the health of our Earth. And you know, it's really what gave people the perspective that we're just this little blue dot in the vastness of space, and we have to take care of it. What if there were 8 photographers or 8 variety of artists on that mission in, was it 1968? What if there was 8 other artists on that mission who were able to articulate the human experience that is going to not low Earth orbit, but around the moon? What does that do to the human psyche? What perspective does that change in how we perceive ourselves and our place in the universe? I don't know. But anyways, I know if you made it this long, this is a very different video than what I usually do. Usually they're very stylized, but I had to talk about this talk last night. There's still a lot more to learn. I'm very much looking forward to seeing what Elon and team have up their sleeve over the next 5 years. What I did appreciate was Elon did say that this is just a target date, and it is everything goes right date, it's likely to slip. So 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, I think it's just a great goal for everybody working towards. And with that being said, that's it. I don't really know how to end this because I usually don't do these walk and talk things. But anyways, thanks for listening to me ramble. I hope that you learned something, and I'm sure there's going to be a video or two made about this in the years to come. All right, thanks, guys. Have a great day.